Recently, there has been a bunch of skins released, and it is hinting that there will be a Pandaren expansion, which means we might be getting a new class called Monk. And it's been a little bit since we had Demon Hunter released, around 2 years starting at the next rotation, and it'd be kind of exciting to see what Monk would be like in a game like Hearthstone. And I think it's important to note that I don't think that there will be a new release class until 2023, as I'm pretty sure they're going to use the year of 2022 to reinforce what they've already done in Hearthstone, like make mercenaries, duels, standard, wild, battlegrounds just a better game mode. And this was actually kind of confirmed in Ixar's AMAs that he does on Twitter, talking about how they have a plan to add another class to Hearthstone, but they still haven't implemented it yet. Ixar talked about how there is no new class in development today, but a lot of infrastructure was added when they did Demon Hunter, so adding a new class will be easier. So I would imagine that we're getting a new class around 2023, usually around March or April when the rotation happens. But it did get me thinking, what would Monk be like when it was released into Hearthstone? What would be its hero power? What would be its portrait? But in this video, we're gonna go through all of that. In order for us to envision what Monk would be like in Hearthstone, we have to look at what it was like in World of Warcraft, what the class did, and what its main roles were. In World of Warcraft, monks are able to perform each of the three group role types, which is tank, healing, and DPS. Whatever combat role monks have, they usually rely on their hands and feet to, you know, do the talking, and they have a strong connection with their inner chi to power their abilities. Some of their abilities, like chi wave, can heal their allies while damaging at the same time, so making monk into Hearthstone is going to be extremely interesting. And just like all the other classes, there is a main character that represents the class in Hearthstone. For example, in mage, we got Jaina, and for rogue, we have Valyra. So who is going to represent the monk class? For the monk class, there seems to be two main characters that we could probably pick from to represent the class. Number one being Chen Stormstout, who has seemed to be one of the most notorious Pandaren brewmasters in Warcraft lore. The other major character is Emperor Xiaohao, who is the last emperor of the Pandaren and is also a revered monk amongst them. The other major question is, what about a hero power? Because the monk class is very interesting and seems to do a lot of stuff. Since Monk covers a lot of different classes, tank, DPS, and healing, it'd be interesting if the hero power was on a rotation like this. Have one for stagger, which is gain one armor and you change your hero power. Have tiger strike, which is plus one attack this turn. And then you have soothing mist, which restores one health. And that is a really cool idea because it represents Monk entirely. The other really good example of this would be something like chi burst, a 2-mana hero power that restores one health to a character and give it plus one attack this turn. Another really interesting example is the Circle of Life, which adds a copy of a chi sphere to your hand. And a chi sphere is just a 0-mana 0/1 used by monks as a second resource because monks use chi in World of Warcraft. The only issue I could see with this example of a hero power is that they would have to showcase this in a really weird way on the UI, which might be too much of a hassle, but let me know what you think of this mechanic. Do you think this would be good for the game? Another question to add is, Monk gonna have a special keyword like Demon Hunter has Outcast and Rogue has Combo? And I think there is a couple of really good examples, the first one being Focus. Focus is an extremely interesting one because Focus would activate when used exactly the mana crystals you have for the card. So for example, if you have 3 mana and you play a Harvest Golem, that would be a focused Harvest Golem. The only problem with Focus is that, well, as long as you're playing on Curve, you basically just get to activate Focus for free, which could be extremely good if you're just playing for tempo. Here's an example of that, which is a 2-mana 2/3 Alley Master, which is not that great. It's just a 2-mana 2/3, but if you do get the focus on this, you give yourself a Tasty Brew, which is a 0-mana card that gains 1-mana crystal this turn only. Another really cool idea would be just focusing on chi spheres rather than having a specific keyword. A great example of this would be Nimble Brew, a 2-mana monk card. Discard a chi sphere, draw 2 cards. And since this would be used with your hero power, this is a pretty good idea. This kind of idea amplifies some strategic gameplay, whether or not you want to use your hero power a turn early to set up a chi discard. I think this could be a really interesting concept for a monk class. When it comes to minions and spells, I think monk has a lot of ways to go because of how convoluted and nuanced the class actually is. Let's show some spells first, because I think spells is where Monk is going to really showcase how cool it actually is. A really cool example would be something like Spinning Crane Kick, a 5-mana Monk spell. Deal 1 damage to an enemy, deal 3 damage to all other enemies. This mechanic allows you to play around a Divine Shield while still dealing with the rest of a board. If we're going to use Focus, Touch of Karma is a really cool example of a 6-mana Monk spell, silence a enemy, but with Focus, destroy the minion afterwards. I don't think that this would be inherently a good spell. May have to reduce the mana cost a little bit, but the card itself is a really interesting idea. Momentum is another really cool example. With a 5-mana Monk spell, draw 3 cards, focus, your next spell costs 3 less. This is like Skull of Gul'dan with 1 mana cheaper, but your next spell is playable this turn. Still not that great, but still a really cool idea to use the focus mechanic. If we're gonna go for the Chi Spheres route, this is a really cool one with Chi Burst, a 8-mana Monk spell. Discard all your Chi Spheres, destroy a random enemy minion for each. Now this card is a little weak, but we can go one step further with Touch of Death, a 3-mana Monk spell, discard 2 Chi Spheres to destroy a minion. Now when it comes to legendary Monk minions, the ideas could be really cool because again, Monks can heal, they can tank, and they can deal damage. Yulon is a really cool example of this as a 5-mana 3/11 minion with a Battlecry, restore 10 health to your hero. Pretty good stats and a really good Battlecry that is much needed in Hearthstone right now. Neo Zhao is another really cool example as a 5-mana 4/12 taunt minion with the Battlecry to give another minion taunt. Now, this card might be a little bit too strong at 12 health, but the idea of a huge taunt as monks would be protecting something would be really cool. We also have the version with Chi Spheres as Isa Cloudsinger, a 6-mana 4/4 taunt monk minion, which has a Battlecry to give this minion +2 health for each Chi Sphere you have in your hand. This card might be a little bit weak, but again, the numbers could be rotated. It's more just about the actual design. There's also G Firepaw, which is a 6-mana 4/4 charge minion with a Battlecry to discard all your Chi Spheres. Give this minion +2 attack for each. So there is the trade-off of having the taunt side and the offensive side. Monks could also have a weapon like Audacious Staff, which is a 2-mana 1/2 weapon. Whenever you attack, gain 1-mana crystal this turn only. This is like paying 2 mana to save 2 mana later. That's a really cool idea. Another cool example would be Fist of Fury, a 4-mana 1/4 weapon. Every time you activate focus, gain +1 attack. Really cool concept, and it just fits so nicely into what Monk would want to do. If you want to see the rest of the cards from this video, I will put the link in the description. This was from a Moz and another user on Hearthstone who came up with their own classes, and I thought this would be a super fun video. So I hope you ended up enjoying, and if you did, I would really appreciate this description. You look fantastic.